There's no better testimony to any product than how they actually work in the field. Let's take a look at a few hunts showing you just how effective these Redneck Bale Blinds really are. For this first hunt, it's the kickoff of the rut, November 1st. And this is a perfect scenario. This is the first mature buck that I've got to see so far for my season. And he followed this doe down to the food plot. And this is a doe that was a regular down to this food source. And we had let her pass for the entire beginning of the season for hopes that she would eventually have a big boy follow her down. And this is exactly what we need as bow hunters, is a big buck to finally have enough nerve to show himself in the daylight and make one mistake that's going to give us the shot at a buck of a lifetime.
Give that dismount about a 7.5. But here's our setup bale blind down here on some buck forage oats. Check out that setup right there. Just what more could you ask for? That is an awesome buck. Wow. First buck with my Hoyt carbon spider too. Oh man, how's he looking? What's awesome? Wow, he's big old body too. 4 year old, I think. Is that Vader?
That's Vader.
It is Vader, isn't it? Look right there, short brows. Folks, if you're one of us Midwestern whitetail fanatics, then you're gonna definitely understand that this past year, or the past year, I guess, and a half, has been an absolute nightmare for EHD. And you know, we've got one mature buck on the ground right now. I know that, but I had over 20 something bucks that I found last year, casualties of EHD, and it's been really, really tough. We told ourselves if we find a 4 year old deer, we are going to take that deer for sure. And this buck, we nicknamed him Vader. He came in, and man, I can smell him. He's so rutted up. absolutely textbook. It's November 1st. We were on the food. We knew that big bucks are eventually going to follow the does to the food. The does come to the food all the time. We've left the does alone, so they felt comfortable coming. They felt comfortable with the blinds. And here it is, November 1st, the kickoff of rut. And good old Vader follows that doe that we've seen probably four or five times from that blind, follows her right down. Offered me a good shot. I pulled back the first time. To be honest with you, when we saw him, I didn't have an arrow knocked. And I don't think I clipped my nock all the way on the string. I pulled back and it came off the string. He heard that. I loaded again, drew back, and I actually anticipated him to duck the arrow. But he didn't flinch. He was just worried about the doe. And I hit him pretty much exactly where I aimed. Perfect shot, tons of blood, Ulmer Edge, my brand new Hoyt Carbon Spider, my buddy Mark, my lucky charm. And we're here on my good friend Dustin's place. And we work as a team. We help each other, and here's what happens. An awesome buck. Knock on, everyone, right here from Iowa.
Ripper shot. That is sweet. Awesome morning down here in my Redneck Bale Blind. This thing is just the killing machine. Came in here set up last night. These gobblers roosted probably a half mile away. We got them called all the way here. They actually came right by my buddy Mark in the other blind. We definitely seen arrows flying. I'm not sure the result. One bird went off. But these guys were a little bit boogered up. So when they were coming across, I didn't think they were going to come in and give us a show. So I went ahead and took a shot. Ripper of a shot.
Good shot.
Yeah.
Oh, that's sweet.
Talk about a perfect, perfect morning for turkey hunting down here in Missouri. And just, I don't know what more you could ask for. Mornings like this just make me so thankful to be an outdoorsman and be able to see things. And I saw some cranes this morning and heard some birds. I don't even know what planet they were from, the weirdest sounds I've ever heard. But you know what, that's part of being a hunter. You get to enjoy all that. Came out here, set up the Redneck Bale Blind, and once again, it's batting 100%. Everywhere we put one, birds are going down. Here's our setup this morning. Decided to go with two hens, just because back home in Iowa, the birds are still a little bit, they're kind of henned up, they're a little bit shy of getting in fights so far. I've never had a group of five longbeards come out in Iowa yet, but that's what happened here. Obviously, you guys saw what happened. Mark had quite the display over on his blind, but I can't wait to see this bird. This bird looked like a giant. It was a longer shot than what I'd prefer on a turkey, but it was my last resort. Wow. What a gobbler. This is, there's my arrow. I'm shooting a Easton carbon bowfire with a 2-inch mechanical Ulmer Edge. You saw what it did. Dude, 3 beards. Holy smokes, I knew he had a rope. I didn't know it was, can you see that? Look at that. Look at the size of each of those beards, dude. Wow, awesome. Great spurs. Look at the spurs. Look at the thickness of those spurs. Just an awesome, awesome bird. Gorgeous fan as always, but nothing's comparing to those 3 beards right there. That's gotta be 25 inches of beard. Just a spectacular morning down here, hunting with some good friends. Got my man TJ behind the camera. We just met yesterday and I really wanted to get out and share a hunting blind with him. And I guess definitely got to give some credit to my bow, my spider. This thing's just making bites on everything it shoots at, and having my Sherlock, something that I can just really fine tune my yardage, make sure even when I have to make a rip of a shot like this, goes right where I want it to go. Just an awesome, awesome, awesome bird. Look at the size of that. We'll have to paint the barn with that, TJ, when we go back. Need to paint the barn. Thanks everybody for watching. Stay tuned. Knock on. Hey everybody, you just watched another super successful hunt with the bale blind, and I'm just gonna tell you right now what really separates the redneck bale blinds from any other blind that's on the market, because this is a total system. This is a complete package that's built to last. It's made of the highest quality materials, and obviously when you see it, it's the most realistic hay bale blind there is, period. But just like with any product, it's not just about what's on the outside, it's about what's on the inside and the engineering behind it that really separates it. And these things are made from aluminum. It's got a super high quality, ultra durable aluminum frame that's made to go together easy, but it's made to last with wind, with heavy loads. It's made to bear some snow load, and it goes together really simple with one set bolt and nut. You can put it together in about an hour once you follow the directions correctly. And from there, the covers are made with a bungee cord system that allows you to put the covers on once the frame is built and easily attach them so that they're solid, just like what you see here, but also remove them so that during the off season, you're able to store your covers and easily keep your frames outside. Once these are built, they're built to last. You really gotta see all these awesome features on the redneck bale blinds. The hand-sewn blanket easily attaches to the frame itself using this bungee cord system that's actually sewn into the blanket itself. All you have to do is take the bungee cord and hook them around the already installed screws that are on the frame in the strategic locations. And as you can tell, your blanket's fully installed. Let me show you another great feature to the redneck bale blind, and that's this door system. It really is different than anything else out there. It utilizes a very unique engineered system utilizing magnets so that you can easily open or close your door and quietly. Once you're in, you're able to utilize a secondary bungee system to fully secure the door, or if you're gonna leave the blind for an extended period of time, you can utilize that system as well. Also, this door opening is made large enough for any size man. I'm 6'5", 230, and I have no problem going in or out of this blind, even with my hunting packs or any of my gear. The last thing is you'll notice that on all four corners of the bale blinds, there's a peek hole system with a horizontal window
that has a super quiet and easy to use flap that's perfect for not only looking out, but also utilizing any type of firearm. The Redneck Bale Blinds have a really unique system that allows them to be wheelchair accessible. All you have to do on your main door frame post right here is remove the wing nut that's going to be down here on the bottom, pull that bolt, and that allows you to slide these two frame bars up out of the way so that someone with a wheelchair can easily come in, and then you can once again easily put these down and reinstall your nut and bolt to have a perfect hunt. The Redneck Bale Blind window system is super cool because it's ultra quiet and it's super easy to move. As you can tell right now, they easily slide up, they're super quiet, and what you'll find with these is they actually tailor these to suit either a gun hunter or a bow hunter. And I'm gonna fill you in on a little trick that I've learned. As a gun hunter, you know, you're able to shoot with a lot smaller window. So what I found is if you use the regular hay bale side, you know, obviously you're able to slightly slide it down. You don't have to worry about any of the animals getting used to a black window or a black square. Now, as a bow hunter, since I normally like to have my window all the way open and I have a much bigger black square, I've gone ahead and turned the windows backwards so that the black side is always facing out. And as I have them out for the entire season, all the animals get used to always seeing that black square there. So they don't really know whether the window is up or down. And it's really helped improve my success. And as you've seen from some of the footage that we've shown you with mature whitetails, they're just completely oblivious to the Redneck Bale Blinds. I credit a tremendous amount of my success to being able to stay in my blind. And a big part of that has to do with being comfortable. And as you can tell right now, the Redneck Bale Blinds have a tremendous amount of room in here. You have room for several people. You easily have room, even with a big person like me with a 31-inch draw length, to easily draw your bow or shoot your gun. Again, staying in your blind is the determining factor for being successful, and having comfort like this is gonna make the difference. Your Redneck Bale Blinds are gonna come standard with two temporary stakes, and it's gonna be important that you always securely fasten this to the ground. Now, these temporary stakes work good in both corners, but especially if you're in an area that has any type of high wind situation, the best way to secure your Redneck Bale Blind permanently is to utilize a large T-post in the ground, and then on this vertical bar right here, secure this part of the frame to the T-post utilizing either a heavy-duty zip strip, several, or a heavy-duty hose clamp system. One last thing to consider, regardless of what kind of blind you use, is the Redneck portable hunting chair. This is a chair that's unlike any on the market. As you can see, it's easy to tote around, it's super compact, and it's lightweight, but yet it's built for the biggest of guys. This thing has three individual adjustable legs, so you can make sure you're level regardless of what kind of ground you're on. To open this up, all you have to do is remove this quiet bungee cord on the back, pull the back leg out, and then drop the main seat down, and it has a pivotable swivel seat. You can adjust this to where you can lean back. You can stay more vertical if you want. This chair is an unbelievable chair at an unbelievable price. Check out the Redneck portable hunting chair.